evening. But basically, the years we've known Al, quite a few now, basically, he's formed as much of making our sense of humour as anyone, so if this speech is a bit crap, you can blame him.
For those of you that are wondering why the two best men stood up here today, it's perfectly simple, really. Al wanted to appoint a best man for the occasion, but sadly he couldn't find one. We had to go with two burly comps of one. Joking apart, we'd like to thank everyone for making the effort to be here today. We know there's a lot of people here from all over the country. So just give yourselves a round of applause for being here.
I'm sure that you'd agree that the bridesmaids all look fantastic. Yeah. And of course, the bride was absolutely stunning. And I'll say to Al, don't worry, because basically you're going to do it for me, so I've got to be nice to you. So, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Mark, or for storage purposes, at the Valley.
And I'm Liam, or Toby, as some people do know me.
But anyway, for those of you who do know us, well, we apologise.
Preparation of this speech was that it's traditional to embarrass the groom in the best man's speech, but of course, I was perfectly capable of doing that all night. As for the time, we all went bowing. You're listening to it because some people know this story already. It was a Saturday afternoon. I finished work early, so I rang out and asked him to rally up the troops. We're all off out. The plan was we'd go for something to eat, lie on our stomachs, go and shoot some pool, go for a game of bowling, then catch a midnight flick. So, off we go. Sounds like a good night for the lads. I'll do the show for him, because I'm the only non-drinker. So after eating, down with some pints and balls, it's off to the bowling alley for a few friends to bowl a filler. So we're all playing well. Al's knocking them down each dive. The beer, not the pins. When we look up, and it's 11:30, so I said to the lads, drink up, and we'll make a move. We get to the pitches, Al gets out of the car, and says, I'll catch up with you in a minute, and he heads off to the bushes. No, no, Al can't take his day off. So I said, right, I'll lock the car up, and we'll meet you in the... So we're walking down to the cinema, and all I can hear is this, behind me, so I looked up, and Alan says, you've got to take me back to the bowling alley. I said, what's the matter? Have you lost your wallet? He says, no, just take me back. We've got to go back. So I look at him and I say, look, mate, we just don't have time. Looking at the clock now, it's 2:45. We've got 15 minutes to get in there, get sorted, get our munchies. We're just not going to have time. Please, man, take me back. I look at him. He's got a really nice silk shirt on, a nice pair of slacks, and red and blue bowling shoes. The thing is about Alan, you must know, a few weeks later, we're all walking around, and everybody else is wearing these shoes. So in my eyes, the man's a trendsetter.
Most importantly, we'd like to congratulate the happy couple, because for everyone who's known them like we have, see what a brilliant couple they are. They suit each other really well, complement each other. So, if you can all be upstanding, make the turn.